Hi friends, welcome to the lecture of Advanced Discrete Mathematics. In last lecture we have started our new chapter, which is a tree, and in that lecture we have seen what is a definition of acyclic graph, what is a tree, and we have proved our theorem. Now today we are going to prove some results on tree,
that is theorem.
If T be any tree with at least two vertices and P be a path which is from vertex U0 U1 to vertex UN, be a longest path in a T which is of length N, that is there is no path in T of length greater than N. Length of a path P is N and path P is a longest path. It means that there is no path of length greater than N in tree T. Then we have to prove that the vertex U0 and UN have degree 1.
So we have to prove the degree of the vertices. To prove that, degree of vertex U0 equal to degree of vertex UN will be equal to 1.
If possible, suppose that degree of U0 is greater than 1. As degree of U0 is greater than 1, then there are more than one vertices are incident on a vertex U0. Let edge
F equal to U0 U1 contributes 1 to the degree of vertex U0.
But give, we have assumed that degree of a vertex U0 is greater than 1, then there are some other edges other than vertex F on vertex U0, other than edge F on the vertex U0. So let E be an another edge incident on vertex U0 and vertex any vertex V of the tree T.
Since
as degree of U0 is greater than 1 and F is the first vertex which is incident on vertex U0. So there is another edge E which is incident on vertex U0 and some other vertex of a tree T. Then there are two possibilities for a vertex V. either vertex V is a belonging to path P or it is not a member of a path P, then there are two cases for vertex V. First case, suppose that if vertex V is in path P. If vertex V is in path P, then vertex V equal to UI for some I where I lies between 1 to N. Since path P contains N plus 1 vertices, which are U0, U1, U2, up to so on, UN. And V is a member of path P, then V equal to UI for some I where I lies between 1 to N. Now, if V equal to UI in a path P, then we get a cycle C in a graph G. C equal to U0, U1, U2, up to so on. Here we get vertex UI and vertex UI, which is a vertex V, which is adjacent with the vertex U0. So, by the definition of cycle, it gives one cycle in a graph G. So, but given that T is a tree, as T is a tree, which implies there is no cycle in G, there is no cycle in T. No cycle in T. As there is no cycle in T, but here we get one cycle, so we get a contradiction to our assumption. So our assumption is wrong. Which assumption? That is a that T is a tree, and which is due to our wrong assumption, that is a degree of U0 is greater than 1. So degree of U0 must be 1 for that case. In that, which one is the case? That is vertex V is belonging to path P. Then there is only one possibility for a vertex V, which is that the vertex V is not a member of path P. If V is not a member of path P, this one is the another possibility for a vertex V. If V is not a member of path P, then we get another path P1 from path P is from vertex U0, U1, U2, up to so on, UN. And V is a vertex which is adjacent with vertex U0. So here we get one another path P1 which is from vertex V, U0, U1 to UN, and the length of this path is, the length of a path P is N, which is from U0 to UN, and length of this path and vertex V is adjacent with U0, that is there is one more edge than path P, and length of a path P is N, so the length of a path P1 is N plus 1. So length of path P1 is N plus 1, which is again contradiction to our assumption, since we have assumed that P is the longest path in a tree T. It is given in our statement that P is the longest path in a tree T, but here we get one path P1 which have long path than the path P. So here we get a contradiction, hence our assumption is wrong. That is our assumption, degree of U0 is greater than 1, is wrong in both the cases. That is, vertex V is either a member of path P or it is not a member of path P. So our assumption is wrong. That is, degree of U0 is not greater than 1, which implies degree of U0 must be equal to 1. And similarly, we can prove that
Similarly, we can prove that degree of vertex UL is also 1. From this, we conclude that from this result, for any tree with at least 2 vertices, has more than 1 vertex of degree 1. Okay. Now, the next theorem is let G be a tree with n vertices with precisely minus 1. We have to prove the result that if G be any tree with n vertices, then we have to prove that the tree G has precisely n minus 1 edges. We shall prove this theorem by using the mathematical induction on set of vertices, that is n. We shall prove by using the mathematical induction on n. Yeah. In step one, let n equal to 1. And n is nothing but the number of vertices. It means that the tree G has a single vertex, and the nature of G is, tree, which is given. As G is a tree, then G is a connected acyclic graph. It means there is no cycle in a graph G, and here there is only single vertex. Then the possible edge in a graph G, if n equal to 1, is a only loop. And as G is a tree, there is no loop in a graph G, which implies there is no loop in graph G. As for single vertex, the only possible edge is a loop, and which is not present in graph G. Since G is a connected acyclic graph, that is G is a tree, it means there is no cycle in graph G, and loop is a cycle of length 1. So there is no loop in a graph G. If n equal to 1, then the number of edges in a graph G is if n equal to 1 is 0. So the result is true for n equal to 1. Since if n equal to 1, then by given statement it has precisely n minus 1, that is 1 minus 1 equal to 0 edges, and which is a true. Now in step 2, we have to assume that Step 2. result is true for G. That is, if G is with K edges, then it has precisely K minus 1 edges. Sorry. If G is a tree with N vertices, then it has precisely K minus 1 edges, which is our
induction step in a mathematical induction.
Now we have to prove that in step 3, to prove that the result is true for N equal to K plus 1. That is, if G is tree with K plus 1 vertices, then we have to prove that G has K edges.
Okay. Now, given that G is a tree,
as G is a tree, which implies G is connected a cyclic graph. As G is connected a cyclic graph, then any pair of vertices in G are connected by precisely one path from previous theorem.
Since last lecture we have proved that U and V be any vertices of a tree, then there is precisely one path from vertex U to vertex V. So as we are given that G is a tree, then any two vertices in a graph G are connected by a precisely one path in G.
So let the graph G has a vertex U with degree 1.
As it is a tree, then such a vertex is possible. Let U be such a vertex which has a degree 1 in a tree T.
Let E be an in G whose n vertices are vertex U and vertex V.
Now we have assumed that U is a vertex of degree 1 and edge E is incident on a vertex U. It means that there is no edge other than edge E on vertex U, since degree of U is 1. Let X and Y be
any two vertices of G such that the path from X to Y from vertex X to Y does not involve vertex
the path from vertex u to vertex y does not involve an vertex u and edge e is incident on u. So the path from x to y does not involve an edge e also, which is incident on u,
which implies the path from x to y does not involve edge e, which is incident on vertex u.
Now when we remove an vertex u from a graph G, then we get a G minus u as a vertex deletion subgraph.
Then we delete u from G, then we get G minus vertex u as a
vertex deletion subgraph.
Vertex deletion subgraph.
So the subgraph G minus U has one less vertex than G. There is only one edge incident on vertex U, which is E. And when we remove an vertex U, then we have to remove edge E from a graph G. Then the graph G minus U has one less vertex than the one less vertex than G. It means that the graph G minus U has a k vertices. And when we remove, if we remove an vertex U from a graph G, then the path from x to y is still connected, since the path from x to y does not involve an vertex U, and does not, as the vertex U is not involved, then the edge E is also not involved in a path from x to y. So x and y are still connected by a path.
Vertex x and y are still connected by a path in
G minus U, and these x and y are the arbitrary vertices. Then graph G minus U is a connected acyclic graph.
So G minus U is a connected cyclic graph.
Already graph G has no cycle, then the graph G minus U also has no cycle, and G minus U is a still a connected graph. So G minus U is a connected acyclic graph, which implies G minus U is a tree with k vertices, since one vertex u is removed. So as G minus U is a tree with k vertices, then from inductive step, that is step 2, if G be any tree with k vertices, then it has precisely k minus 1 edges. From step 2, graph tree G minus U has precisely k minus 1 edges,
and
graph G has
exactly one edge
less than 3 g minus u. Since there is only one edge removed from graph g, which is the edge e. So graph g has exactly one edge less than the tree g minus u, and tree g minus u has k minus one edges. So the graph g minus, so the graph g has k minus 1 plus 1. K minus 1 are the edges from g minus u, and 1 is the edge e, equal to k edges. So the tree g with k plus 1 vertices has precisely k edges. From this we can conclude that the result is true for n equal to k plus 1, which implies the result is true for n equal to k plus 1. Thus from state 1, 2, 3, the result is true for all n, where n belonging to set of natural numbers. Hence from this we conclude that if g be a tree with n vertices, then it has precisely n minus 1 edges. Okay, now the next point is a cyclic graph, then any subgraph of G is also acyclic. That is, if there is no cycle in a graph G, then there is no cycle in any subgraph of a graph G. So, if G be a connected graph and it has no cycle, then the subgraph, that is G itself is a subgraph, then the subgraph G has also no cycle. If suppose G is not a connected graph, then G has more than one connected component. So, if G is acyclic, then each connected component in a graph G is acyclic. From this, we can conclude that each connected component of G is acyclic. So, each component is a connected and which is acyclic, then each component is a connected acyclic graph, which implies each component is a tree. So graph G is nothing but the collection of tree. For this reason, G G is also called as forest. Less forest. Since G, if G is not a connected graph, then G has more than one connected components. And as G is acyclic, then each connected component of a graph G is acyclic. That is, each connected component of a graph G is a tree. So the graph G is a collection of trees. So collection of tree is nothing but the forest. For example,
this one is the first component. This one is the second component. Here is third one.
So each component is a tree. So it is a collection of tree. The graph G is a collection of tree. So graph G is called as a forest. Okay. Now,
there is one theorem that is going to result on this definition. Let G be an acyclic graph with n vertices. We have to prove this result.
If G be an acyclic graph with n vertices and k connected components, then G has n minus k edges. Proof: let the k connected components are c1, c2, up to so on, c3. Then for some I where I lie between 1 to k, assume that each component ci has ni vertices. Now from this, n is nothing but the total number of vertices in graph G. There are k components, and in each component, ni vertices, then the total number of vertices are n1 plus n2 plus up to so on plus n3. And as graph G is a acyclic graph, then each component of graph G is acyclic from above definition, which implies each component Ci is a cyclic graph with ni vertices. As each component Ci is an acyclic graph with ni vertices, that is, each component Ci is connected and which is a cyclic graph, then each component Ci is an tree. So each component Ci is a tree with ni vertices, then each component Ci has ni minus 1 edges, which implies the component Ci as nr minus 1 edges. Since each component ci is a connected acyclic graph, then it is a tree with ni vertices. Then from previous result, a graph with a tree with n vertices has n minus 1 edges. From this, each component ci has ni minus 1 edges. So there are total n1 plus n2 plus up to so on nk edges. So
the total number of edges
this is for particular CI.
Then the number of edges, the number of edges in GR N1 minus 1 plus N2 minus 1 plus up to so on NK minus 1. That is, G has N1 plus N2 plus up to so on plus NK and minus 1 up to so on K times, which is minus K edges. That is, G has N1 plus N2 plus NK is nothing but N. G has N minus K edges, and hence the result.
Okay. Thank you for watching the lecture.